class of design of concrete structures. So in the last class we have seen how to design the slab by various methods, and two methods I have already discussed in the last class, that is Rankine-Grashof theory and Marcus methods. And after that some parts I have covered also IS codal provision, or with the help of IS code method how to design the design of slab. So today I will cover rest of the design of IS code method and problem related to the IS code method.
So according to IS 456/2000 clause D.1.3, code says moment calculated as per D.1.1 applicable for middle strip only. Similarly, D.1.7.1.7 says in edge strip minimum reinforcement required for slab may be provided. Clause D.1.4, D.1.5, and D.1.6 says about the detailing of reinforcement. And in detailing of reinforcement, D.1.4 says about positive moment reinforcement, 100% to be provided up to 0.15L from simply supported edge. Simply supported edge and 0.25L from continuous edge. So positive reinforcement provided, 100% positive reinforcement provided at 0.15L from the simply supported edge and 0.25L from the continuous edge. Code also says at least 25%, at least 25% continue up to support. Similarly, D.1.5.1.5 says negative reinforcement over continuous edge in middle strip. So 100% to be continued up to 0.15L and 50% to be extended up to 0.30L, and this is valid for edge support, for edge support. Similarly, D.1.6 at discontinuous edge or at simply supported edge, simply supported edge, some negative moment may arise. Reinforcement is provided half of positive reinforcement provided at mid span in x direction 1/2 ASTX positive and in y direction 1/2 ASTY positive. So if I draw detailing of this, so let us suppose this is the simply support, this is also the support, and if it will continue like this, so from the support 0.15L, this distance is 0.15L and this is the detailing reinforcement . So this one is 50% ASTX positive, 100%, and here is also 50% from the support 0.25L, because code says from the simply support at 0.15L and from the simply support, sorry, continuous is 0.25L, at least 50% we have to provide. So from this edge 0.10L and AST half of AST X positive. Similarly, from this support, this is the reinforcement, main reinforcement. So 50% from the support, it is 0.15, and from this support 0.30L.
So dear student, till now we have seen how to provide the detailing or area of steel in a slab. So code suggests that for the positive reinforcement, 100% can be provided, or at least 25% should be provided from the 0.15L from the simply supported and 0.25L from the continuous edge. Similarly, we have seen the area of steel in x direction and y direction. So that is half of the area of steel in x positive area of steel, and in y direction half of the area of steel in positive y direction. After that, I am going to discuss how to provide the torsion reinforcement in a slab, and what is the length of torsion reinforcement in a slab. And after that, I will take problems related to the design of slab, and I will solve it by IS code method.
So torsion reinforcement code suggests, according to the clause D.1.8, torsion reinforcement shall be provided at corner where both edges are simply supported, and this reinforcement provided in four layers. Length of reinforcement is equal to Lx/5, and area of steel in each layer is 0.75 times area of steel in x direction, and that will be positive. So according to IS 456 clause D.1.8, torsion reinforcement shall be provided at corner where both edges are simply supported, and it is provided in 4 layers. This one is first, this is second, this one is third, and this one is fourth. Length of reinforcement or size of mesh is taken as LX by 5, and similarly area of steel in each layer is equal to 3 by 4 times area of steel x direction, and that should be the positive. So if I detail let us assume this is LX and this one is LY. So length of the reinforcement is LX by 5, LX by 5, and this area of steel is 3 by 4 times AST X positive. This is corner first. Similarly, if I provide here and same thing, so this one is LX by 5, LX by 5, and this is the mirror image. This one is LX by 5, LX by 5, and same thing is the mirror image. Similarly, here is also. So these are the detailing of the torsion reinforcement. According to IS 456 clause D.1.9, torsion reinforcement equal to half of that at corner 1 shall be provided at those corner also where the slab is simply supported. Slab is simply supported at one edge. As I told you earlier, it is provided in 4 layers. Size of mesh already discussed, 1/5 times of the length in shorter direction, and area of steel is equal to 3 by 4 times area of steel x positive direction. Code also says D.1.10, when both edges are discontinuous, both edges are continuous, no need to provide torsion reinforcement. So no torsion reinforcement provided or needed. So let us take one problem. With the help of that, we will easily understand the design of slab by IS code method. So design a slab having continuous support over three edges and one long edge. So this is the panel condition. Types of panel. So out of nine, these are one of these the condition of the panel. Three edges and one long edges is discontinuous as shown in figure. This is the diagram given in the question. This one is 7 meter and this is 4.8 meter and this end is continuous, this is also continuous. Question says design of slab using IS code method. Use M25 concrete and Fe415 steel. Use LSM. Live load on slab is 10 kN per meter square and superimposed load of waterproofing is equal to 100 mm thick brickwork and unit weight is equal to 24 kN per meter cube is given. Solution: width of support is equal to 250 mm. It is given in the question. I have not written. Width of support is equal to 250 mm. Ly by Lx, we have to check whether this is one way slab or two way slab. Before that, I will going to calculate load calculation. So overall depth is equal to span by 30. It is 4800 divided by 32, so it is coming 150. So effective depth is 150 minus effective cover 30, so 120 mm. So dead load is equal to 0.15 into 1 into 1 into 25, so it is 3.75 kN per meter square, and live load is equal to 10 into 1 into 1. So 10 kN per meter square, and waterproofing or superimposed load. So waterproofing 0.1 into 1 into 1 into 24. So it is coming 2.4 kilonewton per meter square. So total load is equal to 16.15 kilonewton per meter square. So factored load is equal to 1.5 into 16.15. So it is 24.23 kilonewton per meter square. Second step is effective span. So width is given 250 mm. So first we have to check whether width of support is greater than L0 by 12 or less than 12. So 4800 by 12, so it is 400. So our span width is less than L0 by 12. So width is less than L0 by 12. So effective length in x direction is Lx plus D 4.8 plus 0.12. So it is 4.92 meter. Or Lx plus W. So 4.8 plus 0.25. So it is 5.05. Whichever is less. So L effective in x direction is 4.92 meter. And similarly, L effective in y direction is Ly naught plus D, so 7 plus 0.12, or Ly naught plus W, so 7 plus 0.25, whichever is lesser value. So L effective in y direction is 7.12 meter. So we can check L effective y divided by L effective x. 7.12 divided by 4.92, so it is 1.45 less than 2, so it is the case of two-way slab. Third, so it will, condition is given, the panel, and the panel condition exists in the third panel. So fourth, panel number 3 from IS code. So we can choose the value of alpha x is equal to negative value is 0.065. Similarly, alpha x positive 0.049, alpha y negative 0.037, and alpha y is positive jo hoga, that is 0.028. So the fourth step is moment. And moment is alpha into W into Lx square. So alpha into W factor load is 24.23 into 4.92 whole square. So it is coming 586.52 alpha. So moment, if I compute in a tabular form, alpha value of moments D in mm, area of steel, so mx negative, alpha is 0.065. so moment is 38.12 kilonewton meter, and effective depth we can check. So effective depth can be computed mu max divided by q into b. So for the first trial, 38.12 into 10 to the power 6 divided by 1000 into q is equal to 0.138 into 25. So it is coming 105 mm. It is less than 120 mm. So okay. So provide D is 120 mm. Similarly, mx positive. So value of alpha x read from the code table 26. So it is coming 28.74. And depth is coming 120. My negative 0.037, moment is coming 21.7, D is 120 and My positive 0.028, it is 16.42 and 120. Similarly, area of steel can be computed. So area of steel required. So area of steel MU is equal to 0.87 FY AST D minus 0.42 XU or 0.87 FY AST D minus 0.42 into 0.87 FY AST divided by 0.36 FCKB. So with the help of that area of steel, if I compute area of steel, so the for first case it is coming 1026 mm square. For the second case 739, 542 and 402. Spacing can be provided also. If I provide diameter of 12 mm, so spacing is coming 110.2. Similarly 10 mm, so it is coming 106.3, 144.9, 190. So provided spacing, with the help of that we can decide. So how will you compute spacing? So spacing is equal to 1000 divided by N and 1000 divided by AST divided by pi by 4 into phi square. So with the help of that we have computed the spacing. 8th step is distribution of bar is equal to 0.12 divided by 100 into 1000 into 150. So it is coming 180 mm square. Similarly, we can check for the shear also. So 9th step is check for shear. So as I told you, shear force along shorter direction is Wu into Lx by 3, and similarly shear force in longer direction is Wu into Lx into R by R plus 2. So shear force in y direction, that will be the maximum. So 24.23 into 4.92 into R is 1.45 plus 2. So it is coming 50.10 kilonewton. So nominal shear stress tau Vu is equal to Vu by BD. So 50.10 into 10 to the power 3 divided by B is 1000 into D is 120. So it is coming 0.42 newton per mm square. So percentage of steel for 50% curtailment. Thousand by 200 into pi by 4 into 10 square divided by 1000 into 120 into 100. So it is coming 0.33%. So for M25 grade of concrete and PT is equal to 0.33%, tau C is coming 0.401 and our tau V is 0.42. So no curtailment means tau V is greater than tau C. So failed, no curtailment allowed. Similarly, we can check for the development length and tension reinforcement. So the last step is check for development length, and development length LD less than equal to 1.3 M1 by V plus L0, or LD can be computed as 0.87 FY 5 by 4 tau BD. So with the help of that and M1 by V, we can compute or we can check whether development lane is less than or not.
So dear learner, today we have seen the how to design the slab by IS code method. So we have seen the various provision suggested by the IS code 56-2000, that is D.1 to D.1.11. And after that I have taken one problem, and in the problem we have seen how to design the slab. So the first step in the design of slab by IS code method, we have to compute the load computation, and load computation is same as by the whatever we have done in the previous two methods. And once we have computed the load, so factored load is computed, and the second step is compute the effective span. So effective span, that depends on whether our slab is simply supported or continuous. With the help of that we have computed the effective span. Once we have computed the effective span in x and y direction, so we have seen the ratio of longer span to the shorter span, and if the longer span to shorter span ratio is less than 2, so our slab falls in 2-way slab. Once we have decided the, we have to design the 2-way slab, after that we have to read the value of bending moment coefficient alpha in negative value and positive value with the help of LEYX divided by LE effective X. And once we have chosen the value from the table number 26, then we have to compute the value of moment, negative moment and positive moment. Once we have computed the value of moment, negative moment and positive moment, we have to compute the required effective depth, and required effective depth can be computed as square root of bending maximum bending moment divided by Q into B, where B is the for a design of slab, generally B is taken as 1 meter. And Q is the bending moment coefficient, that is, that depends on the grade of steel. And in the current problem, for Fe415 grade, Q is equal to 0.138 FCK. Once we have computed the D, then we can compute the area of steel. So area of steel is nothing but moment is equal to 0.87 FYAST into D minus 0.42 XU. And we have interchange the value of XU, that is XU is equal to 0.87 FYAST divided by 0.36 FCK B. So there is a quadratic equation, so area of steel can be computed. Once we have computed the area of steel, so we can decide the spacing or spacing. For the spacing, we have to decide the diameter of the bars, and spacing can be computed as 1000 by N, where N is the number of bars, and number of bars can be computed area of steel divided by pi by 4 phi square. Once we have decided the spacing, after that we have to design for the check for shear. So shear force in can be computed in x direction, that is shorter direction and longer direction. So maximum shear force we have to compute. So maximum shear force we have taken in y direction, that is Wu into Lx into R divided by R plus 2, where R is the span ratio, longer span to the shorter span. With the help of that we have computed the nominal shear stress, that is Vu by Bd, and for this nominal shear stress is compared with the shear strength of concrete, and if nominal shear stress is exceed the shear strength of concrete, then it will be failed. And in the current situation we have seen the nominal shear strength of concrete is computed. So as we know that shear strength of concrete, it depend on the grade of concrete and percentage tensile reinforcement. So for PT we have computed, and we have computed the value of shear strength of concrete. After that we have to check for the development length. So we have, I told you that development length LD must be less than equal to 1.3 times M1 by V plus L0. So this value can be checked, and after that we can also check for the torsion reinforcement. So the guidelines for the torsion reinforcement is given by the IS code method, that is IS 456-2000, that is area of steel is 3 by 4 times area of steel in positive x direction, and the length of the reinforcement is Lx by 5, and reinforcement provided in 4 layers. So take care of your health and happy learning.